CA Pankaj Goyal, in his presentation, gave some good suggestions. These are summarized as expectation from MHRD. So, I will give some of the replies on it. I don't know whether you have seen it. He gave a list of applicable standards. I think there are 18 standards he has listed. I think there are two standards which may not be very relevant for us. AS16, borrowing cost, and AS19, leases. I think none of you are authorized to go for market borrowing. At the same time, none of you are also authorized to take or procure something on leases. But on hindsight, I find that for startup institutions, sometimes you take property or old buildings from the state governments on some consideration basis. I don't know whether this can be called lease property, but some. Now you can see the list. In the list, you will find that this AS10 is there, borrowing cost, and AS19 leases. 10, but there's borrowing cost, I think it's not applicable at all to us. But leases, as I said, some of you might have taken property from a state government on some consideration basis. So that is the area. I'll give reply to some of these things. First one, get C&AG acceptance. I think a lot of people are agitated, and I also feel sometimes disturbed. Quite a good number of people has asked me whether we have obtained C&AG's approval, this and that. So I have listed. You see, in central government, each ministry follows or works under allocation of business rule. I don't know whether you are aware. That's why MHRD is also aware of its role and responsibilities. It's not that we did not think about it. C&AG is a constitutional body. It has constitutional provision, authorization to conduct audit. So we are aware about it. So we proposed, prepare a file, send it to CGA, because we cannot go directly to C&AG. Government of India accounts are dealt by CGA, not by C&AG. So for anything, we have to go to CGA. So we went to CGA. So we told them, these are the new things we want to introduce. So there was a lot of, as it happens in government, up and down. CGA, Controller General of Account. And C&AG is Controller and Auditor General. So these are two different bodies. C&AG is a constitutional body. Article 149, I understand, 149, 150 is form, 149 is the C&AG. CGA is not a constitutional body, it is under the Ministry of Finance. But Government of India account is compiled by CGA. So we went to them. In their wisdom, they said, within the delegated power, we authorize you, go ahead. We started, we have got so many letters, emails, etc. Then C&AG again came into picture. He said, there are certain statutory requirements. So you cannot ignore that. So again the file started moving. So we gave a long reply to C&AG. We have received a long comments from C&AG. Now we have again prepared replies. And with the approval of our honorable minister, we have submitted a reply. Two things has happened in that case. One of the thing is whether we should retain receipt and payment or not. We got some request also from many quarter, and also on receipt and payment we thought after a lot of discussion in the ministry that receipt and payment should be retained. So again we went to the minister, our honorable minister Mr. Pallam Raju, he has given his approval. So now we have decided to retain receipt and payment. So when you prepare accounts, you can retain receipt and payment. Cash flow we are not insisting on. This is the one change. Second change, two words we have changed in the entire thing. Otherwise the format is same, two words. But officially nothing can be said because the matter has gone to again C&AG. What approval we obtained from minister, that is what I am sharing. And two words we have deleted, that is restricted and unrestricted. Restricted and unrestricted. These two words we have deleted in the from the format. But other than that, there is no change. There is no change. So this is one area I wanted to share with you. Second one is operational manual. Yes, a talk is going on in the corridor of the ministry that some sort of guidelines should be prepared. But right now I cannot tell you what type of guidelines we will be preparing. But once we get all the clearances, then maybe in the form of a circular, something will be sent to all. This is the one thing. Gradual time frame, the third one. You see, when I proposed the implementation scheme, I gave a time frame. I did not say that it should be implemented from 2013-14. I did not say, nowhere. In writing I said that it has to be phased out over the years. That time Kapil Sibal was our minister. He said no, start from 2013-14. So you cannot go against the wish of the minister. So we started saying from 2013-14. It's not that we did not realize the problems. It's not that we did not think into all this aspect. But when your minister does not agree, what can you do? They said start, implement from 2013-14. Of course, had he been in HRD, many more things could have happened. Permit, appointment of professional and external. This is within your competency, I agree, and all of you will agree that you do not require the approval of the ministry to appoint someone on contract basis. So it is your domain. Appoint someone on contact basis, or whichever way you think you do it. We are not telling, we know the complexity. It's not that we don't know the complexity, and we know most of your background also, as I know my background. So I am not a professional chartered accountant. So I know my background, I know my depth. Similarly, many of you might be knowing your depth also, only two chartered accountants are sitting here. So it is better to appoint someone. But don't delegate the entire thing like Delhi University is doing. Don't do that. I think their vouchers are also entered by some people and their accounts are also prepared. In that case, you will never learn anything. Now, outsourcing, many people are doing, many institutes are doing, but the way you are doing, you will be handicapped after some time. Engage someone, take his help, at the same time you also build your own capability. So capacity building. So this is what I feel. So it is up to you to engage someone or couple of people as you need, get it done. Already many of you are doing it in different capacity, different way. Get the approval on e-based software. I think already we have stated that we are developing a software. I am not in a position to tell how much we have achieved. N.K. Singh is here. Govindo ji is here. He is in the core committee to advise N.K. Singh. N.K. Singh is actually the team leader. He is actually writing the software. So some works have been done. It may not be a perfect one. We did try to convince some universities, some institutes that you try it, download, install and play with it. But most of the institutes are not interested at all. Everybody wants a ready-made software like Windows. Go to the market, purchase and install. Sorry, our software is not like that. This software is based on open source and there are many issues also related to that. So it's unbound. We are trying to bring them within a bound. That is what we are now talking. No, you should be within the bound. We cannot allow it to be unbound. Open source is unbound. So anybody can play with it. So a lot of things are happening there. What I want to say here is that each one of you download it, install it and tinker with it. You see, there are many problems we don't know. He does not know. Each institutes are different. We have different layer of institutes. At the top IITs, NITs, IIMs, ISHAR, NITAR, NITs, so many central universities, and within the central university there are so many layers. So each institutes are unique, their problems are unique and solutions also are different. So if you all come up with all your problems, then it becomes easier for us to co-opt all your requirements and develop a good quality software. But we are not getting the response we expect. See, if you think that a ready-made software you need, then you hire TCS or Infosys and develop your software, pay them few crores, they will do it for you. Here we are not spending crores, we are spending in lakhs and it will be free for all. Am I right, N.K.? Yeah. So you also try to understand it. You see, there is a background in all these things. Yes, many people are telling, why do not you hire someone like TCS or somebody and develop a big software and make it available to all? We have not talked about the background, how it came and what initially we proposed, thought and what are we doing now. Now we are only concentrating on central educational institutions. The mandate is for all educational institutions. But we don't want to go into the other side of the fence, because until and unless we put our house in order, we should not try to jump the fence. Secondly, we are also trying to bring certain regulations. There are four regulatory bodies under MHRD. So we are also trying to bring regulations through them. So the software will be made available for all. So these are the ministry level things. Now institutional level, separate regional workshop at school, college, university. So let us come back to that organized separate regional workshop at schools, at school, college, university and other level. We have no problem if you want to organize some workshop, but ministry is not going to directly organize any workshop. None of the workshops so far have been organized by MHRD. Either it is through UGC or through AICT or through CBSE or through NCT or through IIT Mumbai. So what type of things you need, you have to decide. What type of training you need, it is you have to decide. Further to classroom training, some focus group discussion, bagara bagara. So these are the things you have to decide. We will provide you faculty. I don't know your need. I don't know your problems. See, until and unless we get all these things, a proper training module cannot be developed. So if I go by this, then I think we need two layers. First layer, what we are doing here, then below that there should be another layer of training, hand holding, practical training, etc., etc. So we are ready. Besides, one more thing you should know, that this T10K, this is called T10K project, Professor Phadok is heading. It has capacity to reach out 10,000 people at a time. So without moving out of your place, without moving out of your institute, you can also be party to this training program. It is up to you to take the initiative.
If any institution or any university organizes this type of, how ministry will help this institution for practical training?
As I stated, or I am further stating again, rather I repeat, see, we have an understanding with IKAI. So if we organize workshop training, they will provide faculty.
Faculty?
Yeah.
So including practical?
Yes, yes. There is all practicing chartered accountants. So that's why I am telling what type of things you need. You have to tell us. Only then, because then you have to restructure the training program. Here we structure it in a different way. In your case, it has to be structured in a different way. Here mostly it is theoretical combined with some examples and others. But in your case, it may be practical oriented. So the material or the training content or courses will be different. So what I suggest to all of you is that many things have come up in during the discussion. Uniform accounting policy, many people have said, then uniform software, and so many things have been taught. So what I want to say to all of you is that, can I get an independent email from all of you? Will you send me an independent email other than the this fact sheet and other things we have circulated, or certain information I am collecting? Then I will be able to call out the materials and prepare training program in a different way. So how many of you are willing to give an independent email? My email, I think everybody knows my email. So I have two email now. So anbokshi@yahoo or anbokshi@gmail. So either of the email you can use, send your assessment, requirement, whatever you think. You see, one thing is very clear. I repeat it. One thing is very clear. We are going to implement accounting standard. There are no second thought in it.
I may request one thing, sir?
Yes.
Sir, during the registration, we have already provided our email ID and mobile number. If database administration has instruction is passed to them, they can circulate the email ID and phone number to all the participants. It is with IIT.
I am telling you something different. I am expecting an independent assessment email from you. What you have given to IIT, the data bank they are maintaining, I am also having a data bank, I am also having email for almost all the institutes. It's not that I am not having it, this is I who gave them your email. So I am having it, and they have also collected from you also. But your requirement should be known to us. Your problem, either say pre-implementation, implementation stage or post-implementation, the challenges. That's why I said earlier, the each institute is different. Challenges are also different. Each sector is different. So, until and unless we know it is very difficult to structure any training program. If you want this type of theoretical, it's better we can organize. But now everything will be done by IIT Mumbai. Everything will be on website. So they will try to reach to everybody.
Sir, if we are also given email ID of all the personnel attending over here, we can interact with each other and we can resolve some.
Most welcome.
That can be given by IIT Mumbai only with your instructions, sir.
Fine. They will send you. So anyway, these are the few things I wanted to share with you. Now, if any one of you have anything to ask, I represent the ministry and I am the only person who is spearheading the implementation. There is no second person. My only agenda, only job is to implement accounting standard.
Whatever we have learned during 5 days, it's very good, it's very useful, very informative and very comprehensive and very interactive also. But point is that implementation is the most difficult part. Now I will make one request to you, that accounting standards which are applicable, a list of those accounting standards along with a forwarding letter should be sent to all the institutes, because authorities have to understand, they have to give full support to us. Even if you want to implement all those things and accounts are to be prepared following based on those accounting standards, if they are told that these are mandatory and these have to come and these have to be followed by the institute without exception, that will help us in implementation of the new format accounts and accounting standards. So that letter is expected from the ministry.
Very well taken. In this regard, I want to say two things. I think I have circulated that format, applicable accounting standards, I think they have collected. On the basis of that, I will do two things. One, I will identify the applicable accounting standard. As I said, CA Pankaj Goyal has given 18. Out of 18, 2 may not be applicable. So 16 are more or less, we are on the same wavelength. This is one thing. Second, what I am proposing to do, after getting the information from everybody, I will finalize the list and request IKAI to also prepare a checklist. So I don't know whether any one of you have read the third booklet, Practical Approach to Implementation Accounting Standard. I don't know whether any one of you have read it. It has been sent to few days back, I think, before we came over here, few days back it was done. There you will find against number of standard, checklists are provided, checklist, audit checklist. That means the system will automatically will take care of whether you are following a standard or not. But they have not covered all the standards. Even in our software, am I right, Singh?
Yes.
In our software also we are trying to embed it. So, but for that we have to first identify the list of standards which are applicable to us. Then we have to go back to IKAI. We have to request them to prepare a checklist for all the software, for all the standards, and then we will include it into software also. So this is already, I am on the job.
organizations, because if we try to implement, we may face restraints, we may face difficulties, we may face constraints. But if the letter goes from MHRD that it is mandatory and accounts are to be on the basis of the accounting,
that's standards. Why Govind, that's why I am telling Najia, first I finalize the list, thereafter I will send email to everybody.
2013-14 accounts we are finalizing now.
Uh-huh.
So it is already prepared in the old format almost. So this year can we follow the old format?
Because no. 13-14 you have to follow new format. Only one relaxation is that receipt and payment you can retain. Don't play with all these things. It's a Government of India decision. You cannot just say I will follow different path. We have already said, I think for the last 2 years we are telling that you have to prepare your account 13-14 on the basis of that new format.
What we are finalizing to be in the new
format? So in that, when you are preparing the accounts, you prepare according to the new formats, only one change, I again repeat, only one change, that is you retain receipt and payment.
Shall we have some kind of communication so at least we can show the CAG that receipt and receipt not required here?
You see, I told you that after the approval of the minister, the file, our reply has gone to C&AG through CGA. So until and unless we get replies from their end, we cannot officially communicate anything. As we have obtained the approval of the minister, so we are telling receipt and payment to retain. And this thing I have said in the from day one. So far we have conducted 6 workshops. In each workshop I said receipt and payment to retain. I have never said you follow cash flow. I have always said receipt and payment to maintain. So it's not new thing. And of my own, without obtaining the approval of minister, I have said. Now we have obtained the approval of honorable minister. So it is easier for us to say.
Cash flow statement we can dispense with what already it is decided in the…
Yes. We have got the approval of honorable minister.
For dispensing with that. Page 65 of the ministry's instruction is there.
Yeah. I asked that question of whether we have to follow for 13-14. You are saying a ministry will get the approval from C&AG.
I have already stated very clearly in the 13-14 account when you finalize, it's where receipt and payment to retain. I have made it very clear. I think this thing I have said 3-4 times here itself. Receipt and payment to retain. Instead of cash flow, receipt and payment to retain. And don't do any other things.
If you take initiative for at least 1 day training program for operation of Brihaspati.
Operation of?
Brihaspati. Software, just operational part, if you can arrange that.
Yes, we
so
can
after
do
that,
that,
if we download that, it will be, will
yes,
be
we can do that. Is it, you have got his email, am I right? Okay. N.K. Singh, you have given your email. Who are interested, please send your email, your consent. We will organize a workshop for Brihaspati at IIT Kanpur. Because IIT Kanpur is developing the software, but you have to confirm your consent or attendance or so whatsoever you call it.
Yeah.
We will organize
surely
it.
Send the mail.
We will organize it. And even if you say 2 days, we will do for 2 days. Why to talk about 1 day? We will do it 2 days.
I think everybody receive a one Brihaspati URL page. In that page in bottom there is a 2 email IDs are written there. You send any one of them. In the top of URL there is a Brihaspati Yahoo group there. So you join that group so that you are aware of the development of that complete system.
You see, Professor Phatak wanted to utilize the time in a best way, better way, so that you are enriched. Besides, you see, the objective is also to record everything so that all these records are also put into made available online. So it has an objective. It's not that for you only it has been organized. As I said, it is under T10K. That means 10,000 people can be addressed at a time. And all these materials, all these recordings will be made available under open source. Nobody is having copyright. Neither Mr. Banka or Mr. Goyal, anybody. Nobody is having copyright. It will be made available. So that's why it was very, very important for us to utilize our time to the extent possible. We are providing you training, we are providing you materials, we are give you suggestions, you now go ahead and do it. So we will have a tea break.